Hello everyone, it's Creepini and Tina.
Hi.
Welcome to the channel. Hope everybody's having a great day and that you guys are in the best of health.
Yes, with health as always being most important. Today, we're going to take a little look back on some information we gave them a while ago, I'd say almost a year and a half, 2 years ago, on things that you may not know that you're going to need to pay attention to before you move to the DR. We've had a lot of the viewers reach out either through buymeacoffee.com/Caribbean or through the actual comments underneath the video. So thanks for commenting and welcome all of our new subscribers. That they are getting ready to relocate to the Dominican Republic. So we're gonna go over some things that you might wanna consider or think about and that you may need before moving out there to make that transition a little easier. We go through the bumps and bruises so you guys don't have to. So here's some of the things that really stood out to us.
Right.
Number one, definitely the walls. Remember those concrete walls?
Those walls are super thick. And to put a picture up or anything up on the walls, you need a special kind of drill with a long concrete bit just for those walls. So the guys that work, do construction out there, they know exactly what to do when it comes to hanging up pictures on a wall.
Yeah, so sometimes they're your best source and they don't charge much. We had the rods and then the curtains put up and we definitely had to have someone do that because the walls are so thick. And it's great for keeping sound out.
Absolutely.
Sure didn't is. Hear anything. No neighbors. You couldn't hear your, you know, the outside too much, but it definitely blocked the Wi-Fi signal. So that's kind of something that we struggled with in the beginning because our setup for our home, if you guys go back to the video on our home tour, we had a great room and that's where we had our Wi-Fi setup. But when you went back into the bedrooms, remember, no Wi-Fi signal.
Right. No Wi-Fi. Wouldn't pick the signal up.
So we talked to one of his subscribers and a friend, and he said to get a Wi-Fi
extender.
Yes. And that helped with the back rooms to get a better signal back there, especially in the master bedroom because of the television and, you know, us getting our Wi-Fi back there. So, yes, we bought the Wi-Fi extender. Where was it?
PriceSmart.
Yes. And that was about... How much did that cost?
$25-$30, I think.
Yeah. So better to get it in country, honestly, because certain Wi-Fi extenders are not compatible with all countries. And we found that out the hard way by buying one that was not compatible to the DR.
We ordered it on Amazon, went and picked it up, had Venmo pack, and got home and tried to get it to work, and it wouldn't do a thing.
Yeah. Another thing, especially if you know you're going to be transitioning and being out there for a while, is to make sure that you have all your insurance policies, like health insurance and all that, auto if you're going to get or have a car out there, but have them in place a month before I say touchdown, foot on the ground, so that you're completely covered and you don't have to wait for coverage. What a lot of people end up doing is getting the insurance after they've already been out there and then having to wait a month for that policy to take
effect.
So another thing is going back to the Wi-Fi shows and programs from your home country. Us is from the U.S. Things that we want to watch like Hulu, Netflix, everybody loves that, Amazon Prime. You will have the country restriction when you try to stream it straight. So we found that that's thing that you want to get besides streaming, because streaming I always think is the best way to go. We didn't get local cable. We did in our first apartment, but then in the second apartment we did not. So we just streamed. So we put a VPN in place, a virtual protective network, so that we could stream and make it seem that we're still in the States and stream all of our Prime, Netflix, and Hulu shows. It saved us a lot of money. VPNs are very inexpensive, and on top of that, it's the safety that you really want.
Right, and make sure that you your network is secure at all times, because I'm telling you, there's some ways that people can tap into your stuff, and before you know it, you know, you gotta go back in there and change your passcode and everything else. So you wanna make sure that you're secure, not just in DR, but wherever you go. You wanna make sure you secure your cell phones, all this kind of stuff. Your laptop, make sure everything, iPad, make sure everything's secure.
It's rampant everywhere. Humidity. Humidity is a huge, huge problem. Remember that you're moving to an island, so you really have to control the humidity in the house. But irregardless, we had to put dehumidifiers either portable or that little electronic ones that we bought mm-hmm. throughout the house because of the damage to like leather, clothing, furniture especially. Mm-hmm. You really want to have those dehumidifiers in place to help combat that humidity problem. And don't think just because you live inland, we lived inland, we lived in Santiago, we still dealt with humidity. I can't even imagine how much humidity when you're right beachside, so definitely make sure you invest in some humidifiers.
And if not, you'll see on your boots, your shoes, your tennis shoes, whatever you may have, your clothes, your suits, your jacket, you're going to see that humidity begin to come on, you get on your clothes, and you got to go on in, you got to get all that stuff off and the whole nine yards. So keep that in mind.
Yeah. And that brings us me to my next point. There's not a lot of storage units or centers, and plus, why bog yourself down with another bill? So remember to downsize before coming. Bring only what you really think you're going to need, as little as possible, because then you're trying to combat humidity on all your stuff, storage of all your stuff, and you have to pay for all the stuff to get there. So try to downsize. We did do a video, if you guys haven't seen it, go back and see, about things that you might want to downsize and get rid of that you might not need on out here on your second.
Yeah, just downsize it and have a yard sale, something like that. Mm-hmm. Pay it forward and keep that money, come out to the DR and get you something else, probably less expensive than what you pay for it in the box.
Yep. And surge protectors. I cannot stress going to get any type of extension cord or on appliances, especially on like us, it was our washer, our dryer, mm-hmm. our big expensive televisions, the Apple TVs, any of the computers, we definitely had surge protectors on all of those because you always have the electricity going on and off and you do get surges. Especially during rainy season, you want to make sure you're living in a place that has a backup generator as well. We've said that a million times in videos on renting, on buying, on everything. Make sure you have a surge protector and a backup generator in your building, because if you don't have that backup generator when it goes out, especially in the summertime, you're going to be sitting in sweltering heat with your food going bad.
Without no AC on. That's not fun at all. Yeah. Not fun.
So just make sure you stay in a building with backup generators. And everybody asks, how often does the electricity go out? And I'm like, well, I don't know, what week are you talking about? Because, we had a backup generator, so it constantly went right on as soon as our electric went out, thank God. But sometimes during rainy season, it went out two or three times during a day. So ours were immediately back on, but then we would see other parts of the country. Remember during the rainy season, they were out. What was it? It was in the south, right?
Mm-hmm. And sometimes it was in Punta Cana too.
It went out for like 2 or 3 days.
Quite a bit of time.
Yeah, so you want to make sure you have those backup generators. Another thing is when you're trying to get like back to Wi-Fi, if you're trying to get high-speed Wi-Fi, you're not going to get that right away because your credit has to be reestablished. Remember, you're in a new country. They don't know you. You don't know them. And they need to establish credit. So the best way, don't get defeated, work up your credit. Start paying your bills, get things in your name, like your electric, your water, etc., and build that credit up so that you don't have any problems when you need something like that, like getting high-speed Wi-Fi.
Very important. Very important that you make sure that you establish yourself financially when you get to the country so they know that you're there, so you have some credibility. If you need a loan or whatever you may need, you'll be able to go to your local bank and get it.
Yes. Next, as we've said before, safety first. Never leave things unsecured. Make sure that your apartment and homes have some kind of safety protocol in place. Whether it was like us, we had gates, we had electronic access only to the apartments, we had armed security, and we had concierge. So whatever level of security makes you guys feel safe, make sure you have that, because nothing can replace your life. Not even your goods, so I would rather lose goods before I lost a life. So nothing will replace security. You always have to be mindful, I would say, of your surroundings and your things. You can't just leave things out, like you said, at restaurants and things like that.
Right. And when you guys do a consultation, we'll give you the inside scoop, the details of what to watch for, how to be careful, and all those kind of things as related to safety. So in the meantime, between the time, always remember that life is to be enjoyed.
Yes, always remember to hit that subscribe, hit notifications, give this and all videos a thumbs up. And remember that hitting that subscribe and giving that thumbs up changes that algorithm so we can bring you great content. And always remember, all things are underneath every video.
So, until next video.